Sitting on top of your shoulders right now is one of the most complex things in our universe, the human brain, which on average is composed of over 100 billion cells. This roughly 3-pound lump is responsible for your actions, feelings, memories, and so much more. Basically, it's what allows you to experience the world around you. Whenever you think, dream, laugh, or even move, these brain cells are sending perfectly coordinated electrical and chemical signals to each other at speeds faster than you can imagine, at 1/1000th of a second or less. No supercomputer in the world can even come close to the power and ability your amazing brain has. There are two primary types of brain cells. Neurons, which are responsible for signaling, form various networks of pathways and circuits that transmit information to each other as well as the muscles and glands throughout the body. There are also glial cells, which support neurons in many different ways. Due to genetic predispositions, structural disruptions, infections, certain lifestyles, and environmental factors, our neural pathways can suffer from deficits and malfunction, leading to the development of neurological disorders. Current technology is still too crude, lacking in both spatial and temporal specificity, and this has greatly hindered the search for cures and advancement in psychiatric research. But this may soon be changed. Optogenetics is an exciting technique that involves the use of light to control cells. In these experiments, neurons have been modified to express light-sensitive ion channels. This idea was actually originated from a protein used by algae and microbes, and it regulates the flow of electric charge across cell membranes in response to light. Therefore, by using optic fibers to shine light onto cells, it can actually turn a specific neuron on or off, and the resulting behavior or change in animals can be observed in real time. The level of precision this method offers is crucial, as it allows for control over defined events within defined cell types at defined times. The goal of optogenetics is to find a way to control the activity in brain cells without disrupting any other networks, so that we can focus on what is happening at the level of single neurons. Dr. Ed Boyden, associate professor at MIT, states that if the molecules are delivered to some cells and not others, the light being shown onto that network can turn that subset of cells on or off. If it is possible to control these cells, then scientists would be able to study the contributions of certain neural networks to a certain behavior. It would then be much easier to find out what kinds of behavior or disorders specific patterns of brain activity can initiate or stop. Dr. Carl Deseroth and his colleagues have contributed to the expanding field of optogenetics by using these techniques to examine dopamine neurons in depression. These neurons are found deep in the midbrain and play a major role in the brain's reward system and our experience of pleasure. Dr. Deseroth observed that what used to be pleasurable to a person no longer produces the same effect in the depressed brain. The experience of positive things in life is greatly diminished, and that contributes to the worsening of depression. It is known that dopamine neurons become active when something unexpectedly good happens, but their exact role was unclear. In this experiment, certain dopamine neurons in mice were made sensitive to light to test whether or not they actually produced the pleasurable feelings or played some other role. When light was sent down through a fine optic fiber to prompt electrical activity in the freely moving mice, the mice behaved as if they were rewarded and stayed in areas where they had received the light. This is only the first step in understanding more about the patterns that trigger behavioral conditioning, reinforcement, and reward, as dopamine neurons play a primary role in many different illnesses, from Parkinson's disease to addiction. Optogenetics has the potential to revolutionize modern medicine, as it can extend its application to an enormous number of fields, not just mental illness, from retinal diseases and deafness to different types of seizures. This powerful new technique seems extremely promising, as it could bring us into a new era of medicine by helping us understand exactly how specific patterns of activity in the brain gives rise to memories, feelings, and behaviors, and thus greatly expand our understanding of the brain's incredible complexity.